Hi everyone, Saeed here. If you have worked with PowerPoint, you have to be familiar with the infographic slides. These slides are convenient to represent your information to the audience. Today I'm going to show you how to create continuous infographic slides in PowerPoint. First, let's check it out. As you see, the transition between slides is seamless. And it is very easy to design. So let's design it together. Let's start by drawing this shape. To draw a perfect circle, you have to hold the shift key down when you are drawing. Set its diameter to 2 inches. Now hold the control key down and duplicate it. Then change its diameter to 1.5. Select both shapes and align them to the middle and center. While both shapes are selected, in the Shape Format tab, click on the Merge Shape menu and combine them. Alright, let's duplicate the shape. Hold the Ctrl key down and make another copy of it. We want to draw this shape, so we have to rotate each shape to the proper angle. Remember, when you are rotating a shape, if you hold the Shift key down, your shape will rotate 15 degrees, 15 degrees, which helps you to rotate it exactly to the right angle. Now we have to put these two shapes beside each other precisely. First, select them and remove their outline. Okay, let me zoom in and put them exactly beside each other. Now we have to merge them. Select them and in the Merge Shape menu, select Union. Again, duplicate the shape and put them beside each other. Don't forget to merge them. Let's align this new shape to the middle and center. Now we are going to design these parts. From the Insert tab, select this shape and draw it. For a better view, let me increase the transparency of the shape. Right-click on it and select Format Shape. And in the fill section, set the transparency to 50%. By using the yellow dots, make this edge fully rounded and remove the roundness from this side. Also, change its height to 0.5 and adjust it like this. Let me zoom in for a precise adjustment. Duplicate it and put it exactly in the same position. Then increase its height and width. And send it back. Now hold the control key down and select the big shape first, then the small one, and subtract it from the big shape. Duplicate the new shape and flip it horizontally and vertically. Now put it in this position. Press Ctrl A to select all the shapes, then make them union. Now we can decrease the transparency. Draw a circle and change its diameter to 1.25. Hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and make 3 copies like this. Now, draw a rounded rectangle and make it fully rounded. Set its height to 1.15 and width to 3.15. Duplicate this circle and increase its diameter to 1.5. Why did I choose 1.5? Because the inside diameter of the maze is 1.5. Select these two shapes, then align them to the middle and the left. First, select the rectangle, then the circle, and subtract it from the rectangle. Make 3 copies of it and put them in these positions. You have to flip these two horizontally, then adjust them. Okay, so far so good. Now we have to change the color of each shape. Let's start with the maze. These are the color codes that I used for the maze. First, select it, then in the fill section, choose gradient fill. We only need 3 colors, so delete one of them. Select each spot, then choose your color. Also, you can choose any color from the color palette, or by clicking on more color option, you can enter the code of color here. You know, by dragging these spots, you can increase or decrease the impact of color. In this case, I am using the linear type in this direction. Select these four shapes and change their color as well. I filled the little circles with different gradient fields, but I only used two colors for each shape. Let's add numbers inside each circle. Repeat this for other circles and also fill these shapes with your text. Hold the Ctrl key down and select all of them and change their font style to Lilita 1. I will put the download link in the description. Now press Ctrl A to select all the shapes and add a drop shadow in this direction to them. Set the blur amount to 25 and distance to 12. Let's group each title with its number. Select the title and the circle and align them to the middle, then by pressing Ctrl G, group them. Repeat this for other titles as well. Now select the slide in the slide ribbon, then by pressing Ctrl D, duplicate it. Go to the first slide and delete the maze and drag all the shapes to the outside. Now select the second slide and from the transition tab, add morph transition to it. Decrease its duration to 1 second. Also, we have to animate the maze. Select it and from the animation tab, add the wipe animation in this direction to it. Don't forget to select start with previews in the timing section. Alright, let's check it out. If you remember, the template that I showed you at first was continuous. In this section, I will show you how to design it properly. But let me tell you that the template consists of three different sections. You can download this template for free in the description, but the most important section of this video. If you liked this video so far, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, let's get back to the video. If your information is more than 4 parts, you can show them in the next slide. So duplicate your slide and select the maze, then flip it horizontally. Arrange each shape to its new suitable position and change the number of each shape. Don't forget to remove the animation from the maze. Select it and in the animation tab, choose none. Now go to the transition tab and select the push transition. Also, change its direction to the right. If I preview the transition, it will be like this. But let me ask you a question. In this case, my shape was symmetric. So when I flipped it horizontally, it was placed exactly in the path of the previous slide. But what if my shape's position was like this? How could I align it with the previous slide? Because I can't see the previous slide. To solve this problem, we have to activate the slide guides. Go to the above slide, then right-click on the background and add a horizontal guide. Now drag it to this position. I can see the guiding lines in all the slides. So go to the next slide and drag all the shapes to the new position according to the position of guiding line. If I preview the transition, you can see that both shapes are aligned precisely. If you notice, the first slide is blank. You can add your main title in this slide. For example, I'm going to add this title to the slide. Now your PowerPoint is ready.